Hello students, so before solving exercise 6.5 we need to know about a theorem which is called Pythagoras theorem, in which the statement of this theorem is, in a right angled triangle the square of hypotenuse is equals to the sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, so let me draw a right angled triangle. So if PQR, okay, it is our right angle triangle, right angled at Q. Okay, it means that angle Q is equals to 90 degree. Okay, so the side opposite to the 90 degree angle is called hypotenuse. It means that what we have to prove here is that PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square. Okay, this is what we have to prove. So now for proofing, we need to do a construction here, and what we will construct, a line QM which will be perpendicular to PR. So we will draw a line from Q to PR which will be perpendicular to PR. Okay, so if one of the angle, look at this triangle, this is point M. So now look at this triangle QMR and PQR. Okay, so in these two triangles angle R is common and angle M is equals to angle Q. Okay, so let me write in triangle QMR and triangle PQR. Okay, in these two triangles we have angle R is equals to angle R, which is common. Okay, and angle M is equals to angle Q is equals to 90 degree each. Okay, so by angle-angle similarity, QRM. So triangle Q, look, R is common in both the triangles, so we will take R in between, so QRM, then 90 degree, okay? So here it will be similar to, look, first of all we have write Q, okay? Q is the angle which is not 90 degree here, okay? And no, neither it is common for triangle QMR, okay? In this triangle. So for bigger triangle we will take PS first, then the angle which is common, so it is R, and then 90 degree angle which is Q, PRQ. Okay, so now by BPT we can say that QR upon PR is equals to RM upon RQ is equals to QM upon PQ. Okay, now if we take these two as together, okay, so from here if we do cross multiplication, this is RQ, this is QR, means QR square, okay, and it is going to be equals to RM into PR. Okay, I hope you are all getting this. So now look, we have proved this QMR, this triangle similar to the entire triangle or full triangle. Now we will take PMQ. In this also angle P is common and angle M is 90 degree. So angle P is common and angle M and angle Q is 90 degree. So what we will write here, that in triangle PMQ and triangle PQR, we have angle P is equals to angle P. This is the common angle, and angle M is equals to angle Q. Okay, 90 degree each. So by angle-angle similarity we can say that triangle P, look, first of all we have to write this P, then Q, then M. Okay, so here we have P, Q, M. It is going to be similar with triangle, look, first of all we have write the common angle, so here common angle is P, so here also we will write P, then Q, which is 90 degree. Okay, in this triangle M is 90 degree, so we will write M in end, so here we will write Q at end and R in middle. Okay, so triangle PQM is similar to triangle PRQ. Now from here we can write by BPT that PQ upon PR is equals to QM upon RQ is equals to PM upon PQ. Okay, now we will take these two triangles together, these two ratios together. So from here, if we do cross multiplication, we will have to have here PQ square is equals to PM into PR. Okay, now consider this as our second equation and where is it? This is first equation. Okay, so if we add 1 and 2, what we will get? QR square plus PQ square is equals to, look, from here we have PM into PR and here RM into PR. So PR we can take common and we can write RM plus PM. Okay, and look here, RM plus PM is nothing but PR. Okay, so in place of this we can write PR. So from here we will have QR square plus PQ square is equals to PR square, and this is what we have to prove. Okay, so what we have done here, we had just constructed a perpendicular line from Q to PR such that QM is perpendicular to PR. Now we have one angle is common, then what we have done here is that we have proved triangle QMR which is similar to PQR. Okay, because one of the angle of both triangles is 90 degree and one angle is common. In the same way we have proved PMQ is similar to triangle PQR. Okay, by that conclusion we have these ratios as equal. So we have taken two ratios together. Okay, so by cross multiplication we have QR square is equals to RM into PR and PQ square is equals to PM into PR. Okay, now if we add both the equations, we will have, look, here also it is PR and here also it is PR. So PR and PR will common and RM plus PM, and RM plus PM is nothing but PR. Okay, so like this way we have proved our Pythagoras theorem. Now its converse is also true. If PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square, then we can say that it is a right angle triangle. It is a right angled triangle. Okay, let us prove that also. Now converse of Pythagoras theorem. So here it is said that if square of one side is equal to the sum of the square of other two sides. Okay, now let me draw a triangle again. Look, this is P, this is Q and this is R. Okay, so here what is given, first of all we will write what is given here. Okay, so what is given? That one side, square of one side is equals to the square sum of square of other two sides, that is PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square. Okay, now for to prove this, what we will do, we will do a construction here. So we will construct a triangle ABC such that look, so in this triangle, okay, this is A, this is B and this is C. Okay, so such that AB is equals to PQ, we have constructed this that AB is equals to PQ, also BC is equals to QR. Okay, and angle B is equals to 90 degree here. So now in triangle ABC, angle B is equals to 90 degree, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So by Pythagoras theorem we can say that AC square is not equals to AB square plus BC square. Okay, but we know that AB is equals to PQ and BC is equals to QR. Okay, so this can be written as AC square equals to PQ square plus QR square. Okay, but look at the given part here, we have PQ square plus QR square is equals to PR square. So we will put this value here. So we will write here from given part. So what we have given, that PQ square plus QR square is equals to PR square. So from here we have AC is equals to PR. Okay. Now look, we have AB is equals to PQ, BC is equals to QR, and AC is equals to PR. So we can say that triangle PQR is congruent to triangle ABC by side congruency criteria. Okay, and if these two triangles are congruent, then look, if angle B is 90 degree, then angle Q is also going to be 90 degree. So angle B is equals to angle Q is equals to 90 degree by CPCT, which is corresponding part of congruent triangles. Okay, so I hope you all understood this. Now